part of understanding what the appropriate value for a particular plane is involves also understanding the head as a simplified form. If I were to look at my drawing and replace the head with a conceptual sphere and light it in exactly the same way as this portrait is lit, I would be able to observe the way in which the form, which is traveling away from the lightest plane, darkens in value until it reaches a fairly definitive shadow edge. Without the eyes, nose, mouth, ears, and hair, viewing this on a geometrical sphere allows us to see that value gradient uninterrupted. Taking those reflections back to looking at the complexity of the head that I'm drawing, it becomes clear that areas of the light shape, like the chin, could never really be anywhere near as light as some of the value planes on the forehead, simply by virtue of their position on that sphere. The actionable lesson here is, if you're having a difficulty interpreting the values on the form of your portrait, try to reproduce the lighting situation on a simplified geometrical sphere and return to your drawing with that knowledge and that experience intact.